All right, gamers. Today we're going to review Omega Virus. Let's check it out. Okay, so in the game, you are working on a battle station called BattleSat, and you're trying to stop the Omega Virus, which has taken over, and if it controls the battle station for too long, it's going to use its super weapons to destroy Earth. Now, you are these four space adventurers, and these are all painted figures here. My set came with painted figures. But as you can see, they are the color of their base right there. And you're one of these characters, and you're trying to find out where the Omega Virus is and destroy it. Now, each character is going to start in their particular landing bay. So, for instance, if I'm red, I'll start here in red landing bay, yellow, green, blue, and so forth. Now, on the start of the game, you're going to enter in your code. And this electronic box has a 0, 1, 2, and R. You will not use R for the code. Your secret code will be one of these other two, any combinations of two numbers on this board. So, for instance, it could be 0, 0, or 1, 2, or 2, 0, whatever you want. That code is going to be important later on when you're trying to figure out where the Omega Virus is. Now, each code is different for each person. So, for instance, if I put in 0, 1 as my code, and I was the red player, and blue player went, and it gave a code 0, 1, because every time you go into a room, it's going to give you a code. Well, if it gave blue player 0, 1, is that where the Omega Virus is for me? No, because that's the blue player's turn, and the blue player is playing his own individual game, and the Omega Virus will be in a particular spot where he put in his particular code. So don't see if you have another player that goes into a room and it pops up with your Omega code that that's where the Omega Virus is. No. Everyone plays their individual game. The code that you picked will be chosen and said on your turn. Now, as you see, the board is really massive. I had to turn everything sideways to get it all in one shot. But each player will have their own little player aid here. And it basically tells you what you do on movement, if you're battling other people, which I'll get to in a minute, and what codes to enter for what actions you wish to take. So it's very nice. There's also a little hole here for access cards. Access cards is what you need to get into those colored rooms. Now, first, everyone starts off with a green access card. So I put it right here and my green access card slot. Now, as I gather the other access codes for red, blue, and yellow, I will also put them right here. Now, as I go around the board, I have choices. One, I can move around and search. For movement, each one of your players can move three spaces on the board. So, for instance, if I wanted to go to this green room, I would go 1, 2, 3. Now, let's say I wanted to go to this room instead. Well, in one turn, I could only go 1, 2, 3, and I have to wait for my next turn to get there. Now, in these green rooms, you may find access codes to the other rooms or probe droids. And these probe droids are one player per color, will each have their own probe droid. Again, these are painted. And if I find my probe droid, I can put my probe droid out on the board. And how probes move is they can actually move from room to room. So for instance, if I wanted to be in green right here and I wanted to go to this room, it would take my player two turns to get there. But a probe droid, he goes all the way there in one turn. So probe droids are really good to have when you're searching rooms for items. Now, other things, like I said, you'll find in some of these rooms, you may find a access code to another colored room. And when you go, and then you can have, like, let's say I found the access code to red. Well, now I can go into red and green rooms. Now, what you can find in each one of these rooms are particular weapons that you will need to destroy the Omega Virus. You may also find access cards to the other colored rooms. For instance, blue will have access cards to yellow and red, and yellow will have access cards to blue and red, and green could have access cards to any of those. In any of these rooms, you could also find your probe droid again in case it got destroyed. That's right. Sometimes when you're searching rooms, it's a booby trap, and if it's you, it'll send you back to the beginning, or you may lose one of your items or an access code. If it's your probe droid, it may just put him up and may destroy him. You may have to find him again on the board. Now, they give you this little player aid, these little sheets, so that you can mark every game what you found in which sector. Of course, the red sector is here, blue sector here, green and yellow, and what room number you went in. And you can also put down, hey, did I find something here? Plus sign, nothing there, or maybe avoid it. You can actually write down danger room, or this is where I found this, because it'll always stay the same for that game. So you can use these. They give you a whole stack of these. You can probably make copies of them just so to ensure you wouldn't run out of them. But that way it helps you memorize what is where on the board. For instance, if I found the Omega virus but did not have the three items to defeat it yet, I would definitely mark it down that I found the Omega virus, and then when I get all three of my weapons, I'd go back to battle it. Now, what are the three weapons you can find? Well, in each of their colored rooms, you can find a decoder, a disruptor, or a negator. Negatron, I think is what it's called. And every time you find one of these items, you're going to attach it to the little backpack on the back there. So like so. And of course, you're going to be doing that for all of the rounds until you get all three weapons. Now, as you're playing the game, another cool thing you can do is you can battle other commandos on the board. You can battle them in rooms or in the hallway if you land on the same space. You'll enter in the code for exactly who you are attacking. And well, actually, who is doing the attacking and who they're attacking here. And then the game will tell you what to do next. Now, it's very simple when you're trying to attack someone. It'll ask you to punch in any one of these four buttons, and you'll hide them from the other player and press one of those buttons secretly. Then it'll ask the other player to punch in their shields, and they're going to hope to press some of the one of the buttons that you just pressed against them. Now, they may get three turns, press in any one of these. So if I press 0 and the other person pressed 1, R, and 0, they would block my shot because they pressed 0 too. But if they hit 1, 2, and R, nope, they didn't block my shot. I pressed 0. And so in that case, the computer will award me one of their items. Maybe it'll award me an access code. Maybe it'll award me a Negatron, which is really what I wanted from them. And I could attach it and then have all my weapons needed to defeat the Omega virus. Yay! That could happen as well. Now, probe droids can also attack other probe droids or can attack commandos. So probe droids can also do the attacking for you, and if they won anything, then it would automatically get sent to your player. So that's another thing you can do, is attack other players. It can be a mean game. Another thing you can do, though, is you can choose to pass. Now, why would you pass? Hey, I'm in a docking bay, I'm going to hit pass, and I can transport myself to any other docking bay on the board. So this allows you to move faster around the board. So the whole time, you're going around, getting access to these rooms, trying to find all the weapons, punching in the numbers on each one of these rooms before the timer goes down and the Omega virus takes over. Now, the computer will tell you whose turn it is. It will decide. It'll say, blue player, go. Sometimes it's BattleSat talking to you, and they're going, help me, help me. And then the Omega virus is talking to you, and it's going, I will kill you. And it gives you a countdown, too. Now, depending on the setting, easy or hard, you can have this set for 35-minute game or a 10-minute game if you think you're really boss. And it's going to count down. It's going to say 5 minutes until I take over. Now, the way you win, of course, is to have all three items in the room with the Omega virus, and you defeat the Omega virus. However, other bad things can happen. While the game is winding down, the Omega virus may tell you to shut down one of the sectors in the battle station because he has completely taken over it and he's locked it down. If that were the case, let's say he said green sector, shut it down. What that player would do is he flip his player board over, and as you see, it just matches right in there, and I don't have this thing pushed all the way in, but it would match right up in there for this player, and that section is completely walled off to any players. Any players that were in that section must move to the adjacent section. Now, as you see, well, it's kind of upside down and far away, but the player board is still there. The actions, the command codes, it stays the same. It just moved to different areas. And that place for your access cards, right there. Very convenient. Now, the Omega virus wins if he shuts down all four levels, then he wins. But if you defeat the Omega virus before all that, you win the game. Oh, 1986, what have you done to me? All right, so final thoughts on this massive board game. This board game is huge. All right, one thing I didn't show you is the guide, which, by the way, the instruction manual is awesome. It starts off with a comic book. That is a comic book to tell you what's going on with the battle station and what your plans are, and it sets you up for the final adventure. How cool is that? Folks, if this game, if I would have gotten this game when it came out as a kid, this would have been my favorite game of all time. As electronic games go, it is probably the best game ever made. I don't know how it keeps track of what all each player has. It keeps track of where you're at. Of course, you have to put that in the system. Such a smart game. The player board's right there for you. There's places to put your access codes. The instruction manual's awesome. How did I not know about this game? I found this game while I was in a flea market in Dallas, I remember. And I saw it, it saw me, and I swear, an 80s rock ballad was playing in the background. I don't know which one, but it was meant to be, right? I was like, what are you? And it was behind glass. And I asked the lady to unlock it, and it was on sale. And I got the whole thing for $30. And I was super happy because the game was super awesome. And the miniatures were already painted. I thought they all looked like that. And then when I went online, I saw that none of them were painted. Mine were painted. So whoever it was also painted them too. Thank you. It is such a phenomenal game. Now, this game goes for a lot of money, but to be honest, folks, I'm going to say it's worth it. It's actually worth it to get this game, especially if you love the 80s, especially if you're into nostalgia games, especially if you like electronic games. There is seriously no better game. Now, I know a lot of people talk about Dark Tower, how it's the best electronic game ever, and everyone wants that game. Everyone loves that game. I actually passed up a chance to play this game at Gen Con because upon opening up the box and putting it up, I said, this game does not look fun. Now, that's just me. I didn't actually play it, so maybe Dark Tower is the best game in the world, and a few people will tell me that. I don't care if I ever get to play Dark Tower ever again. I have Omega Virus, and I think it is awesome. Now, I wanted to turn on the audio to show you, but the mic was having trouble picking it up, and it was very light, so I had to edit that out. But the sound on it is just fantastic. The computer talking to you, the Omega Virus mocking you is great. You are under duress as it counts down the minutes when it will take over. You're freaking out, and you're writing down codes, you know, falling into traps and going, oh man, why now I lost my Negatron. I have to go back and get her. I lost my probe. I got to go back and get it. The game is so thematic. And this is 1986. And Milton Bradley knocked it out of the park with this. So, like I said, I don't care how much it goes for. I think it goes in the 60s, 80s. It's worth it. The pieces are quality. Everything about this game is quality. If you see it for cheaper, definitely pick it up and make sure the electronic box works. That's the most expensive piece to pick. If it doesn't have the electronic box in it, you can get it for like $20 or $15. But that electronic box will sell for $50 sometimes on its own, $30 sometimes on its own too. But it is just a phenomenal game. I cannot talk about it good enough. That is Omega Virus. All right, gamers. All the time I have for now. I'll see you next time. Until then, game on!